Hello, I'm Dave and Hiskey, and you're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel. In the video today, we're looking at why vultures don't get sick when they eat dead animals. Well, it's important to note that many animals eat carrion. Vultures are fairly unique in that they're able to eat carrion that has succumbed to the effects of decay and disease, a feat few stomachs in the animal kingdom can match. As an idea of just how ridiculously hardy vultures are, experiments have shown that they are all but immune to botulism, and that they can happily chow down on the flesh of an animal coated in Bacillus anthracis, which is better known as the bacteria that causes anthrax. They also have no problems eating an animal infected with rabies, hog cholera, and numerous other diseases that would ultimately be lethal to most other scavengers. So how do they do it? Vultures are able to comfortably eat diseased carrion thanks in large part to their highly acidic gastric juices, which are sufficiently strong enough to kill most bacteria before they ever become an issue. For example, as you probably remember from high school chemistry, the pH scale goes from 0 to 14, with 0 representing a highly acidic substance, 7 representing an approximately neutral one, like pure water, and 14 representing a highly alkaline one. While the pH of stomach juices can vary quite dramatically depending on what you've been eating, it tends to stay between 1.5 and 3. In contrast, the stomach acid of a turkey vulture, one of the hardiest members of the vulture family, has a pH of almost 0. It should be noted here that the pH scale is logarithmic, which means each whole pH value below 7 is 10 times more acidic than the next higher level. In other words, in the extreme, a turkey vulture's stomach acid could technically be in the ballpark of 1,000 times more acidic than yours at a given instance. In fact, it's so acidic that it can dissolve many metals. For further reference, battery acid has a pH of about 0.8. Even when the bacteria does survive the gauntlet that is the turkey vulture's digestive system, it then has to compete with its amazing immune system. In regards to the latter, vultures are noted as having one of the strongest immune systems of all vertebrates, and there are few foodborne illnesses that truly pose a threat to it. As for why humans don't have the same abilities, vultures spend almost all of their eating time in close proximity to decaying, sometimes disease-filled flesh. So it's understandable that members of their ancestry who could handle these sorts of things better would, over time, dominate the species gene pool and be able to eat progressively more decayed flesh without consequence. Humans, on the other hand, spent many thousands of years using their brains to develop ways to avoid long dead, uncooked, rotting flesh. That said, humans can eat raw meat, provided it's very fresh, and human gastric acid is strong enough to kill many types of microbes. But there are some bacteria that have no problem surviving our digestive juices, such as the kind that cause ulcers. See our video on the subject, which covers the fascinating saga of Nobel Prize winner Dr. Barry Marshall and his decades-long fight to convince the medical world what actually causes ulcers. Of course, there is a point in which even a vulture will say no and flesh will be deemed too putrid or foul to eat. However, this doesn't necessarily stop the vulture from eventually eating some of the remains. For example, the bearded vulture can live on a diet of 70 to 90% bone if it needs to. In fact, the ability to thrive on this diet is a huge boon for them in lean times, as bones contain a significant amount of calories and will last indefinitely, unlike flesh. So long after the flesh is gone, the remaining bones are still fair game for the bearded vulture. Perhaps the most surprising fact about vultures is that despite their near universal reputation as disease-carrying pests, they are considered by experts to be the exact opposite, and it's observed that when vulture populations decline in an area, the rate of disease will usually go up, sometimes dramatically. Why? As we've already covered, vultures' digestive systems kill off most microbes present in carrion, making them dead-end hosts. So if a vulture eats a diseased animal, the spread of the disease from that animal ends there, because it will likely be neutralized by the vulture's body. This, combined with the vulture's propensity for picking carcasses completely clean, means that in areas with a lot of vultures, the risk of disease spreading from dead bodies is relatively low. However, when a vulture population is displaced, the rate of disease will climb as the bodies of animals are inevitably left to rot and are consumed by, not dead-end hosts, but potential carriers. Further, vultures notably urinate and defecate all over themselves while they eat, which, thanks to the highly acidic nature of their bodily waste, kills most bacteria that makes its way onto the vulture's legs. This also has the side effect of sterilizing the area around the carcass, also stopping disease from spreading. To illustrate what can happen without the vultures in some areas, in India, a massive decline in vulture populations, such as 80 million white-rumped vultures in the 1980s versus only a few thousand now, led to an explosion in the population of feral dogs, estimated to be about 18 million today in India, and rats, with whom the vultures formerly competed for carcasses. These animals, unlike the dead-end vultures, are vectors for numerous diseases. The remains of the carcasses that were formerly picked clean seen by the vultures are also now contaminating water supplies, causing further disease issues. This is more of a problem in India than it would be in many other nations, as only about 4% of their 500 million or so cattle are eaten by humans when they die, with the rest in the past primarily being eaten by vultures. This has become such a widespread issue that significant research was done to determine why the vultures were dropping dead in the country. In the end, it was determined by Dr. Lindsay Oakes and Co. in 2003 that it was the anti-inflammatory drug diclofenac that was highly toxic to vultures. This drug was relatively commonly given to livestock, the carcasses of which the vultures would eventually eat. Given the many thousands of extra lives lost per year in India due to the vulture population decline, diclofenac was banned in India in 2006, with a substitute being developed called meloxicam that is not toxic to the vultures. So thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, please click that like button below and consider sharing it with anyone you think might be interested. And if you did like it, be sure and check out some of our other videos. We've got over 500 of them, so you're sure to find something you find interesting. Thanks for watching.